Intelligent empowerment is about humans and machines working together to play to their strengths.
Artificial intelligence has had the potential to have this level of impact on business and decision making for years, but I think there are several things that have really changed the playing field now.
There are some interesting tools and technologies we talk about on the radar. TensorFlow is one coming out of Google.
Companies like Google are open sourcing these tools and making them available to a wide variety of developers. We really applaud the idea of open sourcing, even brand new cutting edge stuff, to get it out into the world and encourage the use and development of that technology and help find ways to really leverage it and build better software.
Three areas where we're seeing real results today from machine intelligence are around optimization, classification, and prediction.
We have a machine intelligence, Watson, that is helping to read and ingest journal articles and scholarly papers about different cancer treatments. You have these systems that are now not only replicating the decision making of the humans, but also work with other humans to come up with better treatment options and therefore, hopefully, better patient outcomes.
So most organizations have failed to even adopt basic business intelligence type analytics on their existing data. The other thing is that much data within the enterprise is locked up within legacy systems.
But the key piece is really having the right data strategy and having good data in place. But really, we're most interested in how some of the new data techniques and intelligence techniques can support and augment humans and really empower them.
So the data lake is an architectural design for a data platform where all of your data flows into a central lake before being transformed and sent off to systems to do useful things with it. Apache Kafka is a kind of a cloud scale big data message processing solution where you can use message streams to send data between applications.
But when you're looking at an artificial intelligence system, what does it mean to be correct when you have a program that's learning on its own, that is incorporating new information into its model? When you have something that is learning from its environment, that's a very unstructured way of learning. So we definitely have to understand, where does the learning come from and how are we going to balance our desire for accuracy and precision with our desire to understand the rationale and to be able to explain.
And I was talking to a colleague recently who was saying that a lot of people think data is like oil. You just dig for it and you grab it and you stick it in a lake and there it is and you have your data. Data is not like oil, data is like soil. It's something that needs to be nurtured and grown, and you really need to have a culture around how to look after that data, how to source it from the right places, how to nurture it so that really rich, interesting applications and uses can grow out of that soil.
My recommendation to people who want to learn more is first to find a domain that you're interested in and then start exploring the different techniques, because I think having a problem that is rooted in something that you're passionate about will make it easier to start to tease through what are the different capabilities of these different approaches, what are the different ways I have to change my way of thinking about implementing a technology solution to take advantage of these new tools.